Western Esotericism, A Guide for the Perplexed, is a 2013 work of non-fiction by the Dutch historian Wouter J Hanegraaff. Born in the Netherlands in 1961, Hanegraaff is a humanities professor at the University of Amsterdam and a long-standing member of the Dutch Academy of Sciences. Western Esotericism is to some extent a recapitulation for a more popular audience of his 2012 Esotericism of the Academy, Rejected Knowledge in Western Culture. Western Esotericism is a subject whose serious academic study began only relatively recently. Francis Yates's 1964 Giordano Bruno and the Hermetic Tradition definitively broke ground, and she went on to produce a number of other equally seminal works. Meanwhile, in France, Antoine Fèvre, who went on to become a professor at the Sorbonne, was doggedly addressing the same issues in more specialised areas. Volume 1 of his Introduction to Western Esotericism was published in 1986, although it was a full 8 years before an English translation appeared. Fèvre effectively mapped out the field by producing a list of 6 characteristics he considered basic to Western Esotericism. Of course, they weren't uncontroversial in terms of being fully clear-cut or exhaustive, but then academic criteria rarely are. Nowadays, there are a number of highly reputable scholarly works available to the general reader. Two of the best are probably Nicholas Goodrick Clark's 2008 The Western Esoteric Traditions and Cambridge University's 2016 Handbook to Western Mysticism and Esotericism, edited by Glenn Alexander McGee. What makes Hanegraaff's 2013 book different is partly its polemical edge. From a scholarly point of view, he begins by saying, it is peculiar to say the least that a large and complicated domain of religious and intellectual activity, which as will be seen, has been a pervasive presence in Western culture from late antiquity to the present, should have been ignored by the academy as if it did not exist, or treated as if it should not exist. He thinks that to some extent this is because the modern academy was shaped by the dominant forces of the Protestant Reformation, then the Enlightenment. So magic, astrology, alchemy, all of which have a long history in the West, were consigned to the intellectual dustbin as the radical counterpart of everything that educated people are expected to take seriously. This has contaminated the scholarly terminology so that all of the available labels or terms have their origins in heavily polemical or apologetic contexts and are therefore loaded with pejorative connotations in academic discourse. Hanegraaff deploys an argument that he probably owes to the French philosopher Jacques Derrida. What's in the margins or supposedly disqualified within the discourse must paradoxically be a part of the discourse, since it defines its borders. To put it another way, you can't make normative judgments about what ought to be inside without knowing something about what belongs outside. So a proper understanding of esotericism is critical to a proper understanding of Western culture generally, precisely because it's the rejected tradition. Of course, that means it probably has things to say to the modern world. One could not pay a worse service to Western esotericism, he says, than by leaving it to specialized scholars of esotericism alone. On the contrary, its materials are extremely relevant to historians, philosophers, theologians, art historians, literary scholars, and even to sociologists, anthropologists, psychologists, and political scientists. Western Esotericism is a short book, but readable and informative. As well as its apologetics, it contains a brief history of esotericism, a survey of its main themes, a look at its interdisciplinary role, and of course a useful bibliography. If you only ever want to read one book on the subject, this would be a good choice.